The Energy Regulators Association of East Africa was formed in 2008 with a major objective of harmonizing regulatory frameworks like tariff structures and legislation in member states. Today, top executives of the association member countries met in Entebbe, and top on the agenda was working towards harmony.
The energy in East Africa. And this is meant to enhance, first of all, delivery of our agenda of development, the transformative agenda in the economy. But we are also going to use energy as a tradable item. If we have harmonized regulations, it means then the energy can flow across East African countries with defined tariffs which promote and enhance the production and making our products in East Africa.
But as you are aware, we are operating with different currencies in different countries. We don't have a common currency. So right now it's difficult to harmonize. And you are aware the exchange rates are different against the dollar in different countries. The strength of the currencies are different. But that's where we are trying to go.
Officials say they still have a long way to go to achieve the harmonization. But when it's achieved, it is expected to result in benefits that will eventually...
There will be a harmonized tariff, which I believe will be more affordable tariff, because competition brings efficiency. So once we compete in producing cheaply, then we shall have cheaper power in the long run. But also efficient technologies. This harmonization helps us to share on which technology is the best and relevant for us as East Africans. So the technologies we adopt will help us to produce efficiently, but also impact on the tariff.
Benefit final consumers. The Petroleum Authority of Uganda provided an update on the development of the East African crude oil pipeline that will transport Uganda's oil to Tanga in Tanzania.
As we speak, the first batch of the pipelines for 100 kilometers, the first 100 kilometers arrived in Dar es Salaam on Saturday and have been received and offloaded, and will proceed to the coating facility at Nzega in Tanzania. After that, then they will be ready for the installation, welding and installation as a pipeline.
Report by Benan Ojambo for the news.